none of the dreams you had for so very long. Now you had a good run, but don't you know when you're done, you still carry on.
It's not that bad.
I'm up to my eyebrows. That dog could have made all the difference.
How much is up to your eyebrows?
I'm swimming in a pool of debt that comes to roughly 24,770.
You're joking.
Never go legal, Kipper.
Here, that's my mate Alf and the owner of Balkan Prince.
24?
Yeah, the 20's for Her Majesty and the other 4's a minor debt that's going to become major this time next week.
20?
All because I owned up to existing. Pint of poison, please, Alf.
It's a pint of bitter and a large whiskey for me. Have one yourself.
Tell me that.
Well, shouldn't worry, Rob. Things can only get worse.
Cheers.
What you going to do now?
Walk very slowly, Alf.
Walk?
A man with debts like yours has got status. You should have wheels, mate. Isn't it about time you learned to drive?
I don't believe you. It's impossible. What you've just done cannot be done. It's impossible.
You go on like this and you might as well park in there for good.
What's the problem?
Everything.
Anyway, what is all this reversing round the corner rubbish? I mean, do you ever do it? Never. I mean, do you? Never.
It's to prove that you're in control of the vehicle. And it's quite obvious by this last little jaunt that you're not.
Of course I'm in control. It's just I don't like going backwards, that's all.
Forward. Do you think you could go forward?
It would help if you took your foot off the brake.
Sorry, my natural sense of self-preservation.
Believe me, we are doing our best.
I know you are, it's just that I didn't think it would take this long, that's all.
I'm sorry.
Now, is there something wrong with it?
Not at all, it's a very good investment.
If it goes on like this, I may as well move back in, you see.
Oh, I don't advise that, Mrs. Oliver. Always much easier to sell vacant property.
Is it?
Oh. To me! I mean, how could he do it?
It's a pillar, Kenneth.
More than that. A bloody disaster. How did he do it?
He stuck his paw down a rabbit hole.
Well, Mason shouldn't have rabbit holes on his land. What is he, a trader or a trapper? He couldn't lose. This dog couldn't lose. But I've got to clean up.
Yeah.
I've got to turn the Liffey into Guinness.
Yeah, well.
You come across a dog like that once in a lifetime.
I know, I know.
I think we'll have to go down there and break Mason's legs.
What, this afternoon, Pat?
Stick him down a rabbit hole and fill it full of concrete.
We're busy this afternoon.
Calls himself a trainer.
Sammy wants a dozen tickets for Drury Lane.
I'll kill the bastard.
And Nobby can do a gross for the pop festival.
What are you whittering on about?
Business, Pat, business.
Just shut up, will you?
No problem.
Does anybody else know about this?
What?
The dog, you idiot.
Don't just a Mason, you and me, that's all.
Let's keep it that way, shall we?
No, Robbo, you can't drive it. It's my livelihood, that is.
I've got to practice somewhere, ain't I?
Aye, well, not in that you're not.
Is that your final word?
Yes.
I thought you were my mate.
I am. I'm trying to keep you out of the graveyard. Anyway, you never passed the driving test.
Look, if you can drive, I can drive. All you got to know is where to push that, stick.
Your magic.
Yeah.
Anyway, you're too old. You what? You've passed it, man. You know, once you've turned 40, the old reactions start to go.
You reckon, do you? Speak for yourself.
You're over the top. Learn to drive a bike.
Another winner, Jeremy. Oh,
you'll be lucky.
Yeah, look at that. Look at that lovely tombo.
Your ferret. Mind you don't choke.
Oh, tar, Jeremy.
Here you are, Matt.
Dog napped.
It's not funny.
I'm sorry, mate. Yeah, look, yeah. Yeah, I'll get someone out down here.
Oh, yeah. We're going to make a profit like that, aren't we? We're going to have to get through the lighthouse, you know, Rob. Can't you get them on lager?
Dick, listen, are you going to give me some wheels or what?
You pass the test, I will sort out the motor.
But why not now?
Because some people can go out on the road without instruction. It's a natural instinct. Others need a thousand lessons before they're even allowed to look under the bonnet. You are definitely one of the others.
That's a bit strong, isn't it?
We're going to have to sell more shorts and all. You never make a profit on beer, you know.
But why are you so sure that hard?
I've been up the funfair with you. You couldn't even steer a tram.
But dodgems are different, aren't they? They're supposed to crash.
Rob, you can't afford it.
Look, Dick, listen. In this business, you've got to have a bit of style.
Rob?
Right, Robbo. That's about it.
Fine.
And I'll start work after work, okay?
Thanks, Geordie.
Don't thank me. Thank Doreen. Hey, Ferret, what are you doing here?
Somebody's nicked me dog.
Oh, is that all? You look as though you've lost your wallet.
Is that all?
Oh, I'll need another pair of steps for the scaffoldboard.
Out the back.
Right.
Hey, and remember, keep death off the roads.
Mrs. McGregor.
Let's have a look at you. Round you come now. Come on. Now, here, cop that. Let's see.
It's a result, ain't it? Eh?
Not bad, not bad. We'll have to paint the nose a bit, though.
Well, supposing it rains.
What do you think they put in the front of houses? Watercolours.
You're not going to slap emulsion all over him. You want to be careful, Pat. I saw that picture where they bumped off that bird with gold paint.
Sometimes I think you have a brain the size of a pea.
Oh, I was only helping. Yeah. Anyway, I promised him a couple of tickets for the Arsenal next to the chairman.
You what?
Kipper.
Oh, leave off.
He can't tell one chairman from the other, can he, my old son? Eh?
Hang on. Now, look, don't fall off the pavement.
I'm all right.
Good. Now, go straight home and have a sit down.
Won't be the same, will it? Remember when I lost him last time?
Oh, leave it to me. Take him to a bus stop, will you?
Come on, let's go.
You can't ask him for the money, can you?
Yeah. What about the debts? What about the tax man?
Voice of doom, you are.
Yeah.
Your top.
You are going to talk to Debbie, ain't you?
It's difficult, isn't it?
Well, so is life with Christine.
You've seen what she's done with that office, haven't you? She's a right little grafter. Can't you talk to Christine again?
I have.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, like I said, probably won't be a club here by the end of the month anyway.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Right, now, hold steady.
What are we going to do about the registration number?
Uncle Max will tattoo the ears. No problem.
Well, is it going to look the same?
Identical. Once it's done.
Yeah?
You won't be able to tell which twin has the tattoo.
All right, Dick?
You early?
Well, it's different when you're enjoying yourself, isn't it?
Yeah, I suppose so, yeah.
Well, come on, Rob, you're enjoying it too, aren't you?
Yeah.
It's going to look great when this place is done. Before you know it, we'll need a minder on the door.
You get your gorilla in.
Anyone but him.
How's it going, then?
It's all right. But the customers are complaining about polyfiller in their sandwiches.
Well, don't tell the others, they'll all want it.
What is it?
Nothing, nothing. I was just wondering, if you're enjoying yourself here.
Oh, yeah, I'm having a ball.
I was just wondering.
Yeah?
Well, you know, the thing is, up till all hours, working the day backwards. I mean, I'm used to it. I just wondered, you know, whether it was right for somebody like you.
So what's all this about?
No, nothing, nothing, no.
Nothing?
No, I just thought, you know, being a bit older and all that, whether I should advise you to do something else.
Like what?
Oh, come on, Debs, you just left school, haven't you?
Oh, you've noticed, have you? I get it. Mum's been on at you again, hasn't she?
No, no, I swear.
She doesn't want me here and she wants you to get me out.
No, 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 I promise.
Well, who then?
Debs. It's Christine, isn't it?
What?
She thinks that two's a crowd.
Well, get rid of her!
Debs,
now, you listen to me, Mr. Box. I'm not going, I'm staying. I like it here. Anyway, I'm family and you owe me. The only way you're going to get rid of me is by picking me up and throwing me out on the street. And I don't think even you're going to try that one.
Yeah, Ferret, what will you shut up? Every time anybody speaks, it's like being in an echo chamber. I feel as if I've got the old of the Argyle and Sutherlanders bagpiping round my brain.
Ferret, if you can't hold your booze, you shouldn't go pouring it down your gullet.
What the hell do you think this is, a nursing home?
You ought to be old enough to have more sense.
It's fizzing, Joni.
Of course it is, you silly sod.
Don't think I can take the fizz.
Yeah, that's the champagne of the chemistry world, that is.
It's your voice that's killing me.
What's he been doing to get like this?
From memories.
Where?
Robbo's.
He ought to know better.
He does.
Oh, come on, get it down, you. That mutt will come back. Did last time, didn't he?
Here, hands off.
I'm only looking.
I just cleaned that. I don't want your betting shop fingers all over lowering the prices.
Show me. Hey, have you seen Robby?
No.
Well, I need him.
Try Gills.
Yeah.
The club?
No.
If I see him, I'll tell him you're looking.
Yeah, I might get one of these.
What?
A stall.
What's she going to sell? Racing tips?
Well, I couldn't do much worse than you, could I?
Oh, get off.
Tell her.
Tell her. What time do you call this? You look as if you've been to a funeral.
I am.
Oh, Mary, I'm sorry.
No, no, it's all right. No. I didn't really know them. They were on his side.
Oh. Nice, was it?
Well, as funerals go, yes, it wasn't bad at all.
Nothing like a good funeral, is there?
No.
Meet the friends,
yeah.
Relatives.
Yeah. Aye, she laid on a lovely spread.
What, the widow?
No, the daughter.
Oh.
Oh, yes, and there was some good stuff there. We'll give it a few days, you know. And then I could have a little talk with her.
Oh, tar, Mary.
Hello, Aaron. What you got in there?
Music, man, music.
Oh, yeah? What sort?
All sorts.
You haven't got any...
Mantovani?
Yeah. I'm going to need some tapes soon as background.
Background?
Yeah, well, I've taken over this club, haven't I?
Never.
Yeah, I have, honest, really. See ya.
See ya, Robert.
Hello, Mary.
Oh, hello.
She looks like she's been to her, Oh.
Here, Kipper's looking for you.
Oh, say what he wanted?
No.
Oh, everything all right, then?
Yeah, of course.
With you and Tommy, I mean.
Oh, well, we're still adjusting, aren't we?
Well, let's hope you got the right spanner, eh?
Listen, son, you're looking at a lady who slept on a Union Jack pillow all through the war. Oh, he's a cantankerous old sod, but I do love him. All to the point. How are you getting on?
Never better.
Don't believe you.
Oh, sex pot, have I lied to you?
Yes.
Only a bit.
A bit?
Only when I didn't want to worry you.
Let's go and have a Guinness.
It's a bit early, isn't it?
Here, Mary.
Yeah?
I'm going to take my son for a Guinness, all right?
Oh, get us one as well, will you? I need to wash the ashes out of me now.
Oh, Mary. Come on, son. What about this club, then, that I ain't seen?
I told you.
No, you haven't.
Haven't I?
No.
Well, it's all right. I'm just going to take a bit of time, but it's all right. And this time next year, I could be driving a roller.
I just want to be sure that you'll be here this time next year. I mean, I don't want you to run before you can leap.
Hey?
You know what I mean.
You're starting to sound like my mum.
I'll see you later, then. All right, Mum. See you later. Have a nice day. Bye.
What is it, for God's sake? What's the matter?
Nothing.
Nothing. It sounded like that when you were five, when you stole my lipstick and asked you what you'd done with it.
Nothing.
Come on, you've joined our world now, the grown-ups.
Huh. It's a mess, that's all.
What is?
Everything. This tip in particular.
Do something about it. You could start by tidying this lot up. It's only temporary, for God's sake.
Some people say that about life.
As soon as I've sorted the flat out, it'll all be all right. You'll see.
Perhaps we should have stayed in Australia.
Yes, perhaps we should.
It was nice, though, wasn't it?
Debbie, you were the one that came back.
You know, the day he phoned me, I was lying in the pool, waiting for a barbecue to cook.
Debbie, I know you don't like
it. Of course I don't like it. You don't like it neither, do you? He's stitched us both up, hasn't he? He's brought us both back from the good life, and here we are, sitting like a couple of poor relations on Tommy's doss-ass furniture.
I don't understand. I always thought Robby was the hero, the man on the big white horse. I mean, why the sudden change?
Because he only thinks about himself, that's why. And I thought he was on my side. And he wants me out of the club.
He does what?
Well, he said there's not enough work to go round.
Well, that doesn't sound like Robby.
That's what he said.
It sounds as though he pays you.
Well, I said I wasn't leaving anyway.
Oh, well then.
I can't stay, can I? Not if you don't want me to. It's all right for him. Everything's going well on his side of the muck heap, and here we are on ours, waiting for the dustbin men.
Geordie's going to do the decorating, but he can only work when he's not working.
Why can't you do things properly?
He's the best, so it's worth waiting.
Geordie's the cheapest.
He's my mate, isn't he?
I don't know why.
Don't give me a hard time, sexpot, please. I'm really trying.
I know you are, son. And I'm proud of you, really I am. I know you're going to make it.
Just need somebody to set me off, that's all. Now I've got it, I'm going to hang on.
Yeah, you do.
It's going to be all right. I've got a checkbook.
Well, you hang on to that. Yeah. How much do you owe?
Owe?
You heard me.
Where'd you get that from?
Huh? Small bar, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Look, son. You're in trouble, ain't you?
Don't worry, I'll sort it.
This is your mother you're talking to.
That new breather on the start story.
Outside.
Outside. This race is new breather, 2-year-old, over 1 mile.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself, Robby Box.
Old man like that.
Leave it out, Joan.
Bullying him into an early box.
What are you talking about? Look what we did for Irish.
I can't stand this.
We gave him a good send-off, didn't we?
Shut up, will you?
How can you go on like that when it's you that did it?
Did it? He fell under that bottle like he'd come off the Sahara.
Tell me how to cheer myself up. I could have stayed at home and been miserable.
Oh, you call that stone you live under home, do you?
Right, anybody out there spending money? This is a business, not a doss house.
He'll close his head in that shutter one day.
I heard that ox. You leaving me?
Business, Ferry. Business, son.
Look, I didn't want to upset Ferry, see?
He'd be even more upset if you don't tell him where he's running.
Well, that's the whole point. It's not.
What's not?
A dog.
What is this, MI5?
Look, I'm not talking about a running dog.
Oh, it's a code, is it? I've got to break the code.
Talk about his dog.
What, Mrs. McGregor?
I know where he is.
Well, why didn't you tell him?
I don't want him to do anything stupid.
What?
Well, you know how emotionally gets.
So you want me to do something stupid instead?
He's your mate.
Oh, he's my mate all of a sudden, is he?
I'm serious, Rob.
All right, what?
Well, there's this little firmer, they got hold of the dog. I thought perhaps you'd go around, have a word with him, like.
Oh, Darkin. You're a million.
Here. Here you are, Mary.
Oh, thanks, Fi. Here. He's been asking for you.
Who?
Him over there.
What's he want?
I don't know, but he hasn't come to buy. He looks a bit official to me. Pinstripes behind the glasses. Do you know what I mean?
You think he's come to see about the licences?
I don't know. He just asked for Mrs. Box.
Did he?
Yeah. He said he'd been round your place and Tommy said you was here. Perhaps he's come about the income tax.
Oh, leave it out, Mary. Oh, hold on. He's coming.
Yeah, do you want to be a customer?
No, I better sort this out.
Oh. Oh, you seen anything you fancy, then?
No.
No. Well, if you do, just blow in my ear. I can always get your discount, eh?
Yeah?
Mr. O'Connor?
What do you want?
Mr. O'Connor?
You buying or selling?
I don't know.
Name?
Mrs. Box?
No.
Oh, isn't this her stall?
I'm minding it for her.
Will she be back?
I don't know.
Oh.
Can I help you? We are related, you see.
Oh, no.
We don't have any secrets from one another.
No, it's quite all right. Thank you.
She tells me everything.
Huh?
And vice reversed. We're like twins. Well, that's nice, isn't it?
Hmm?
Look quite pretty in an office.
Yes, I'm sure it would. Well, thank you for your help. Good day to you.
It's about a dog.
What's that?
I've come to see a man about a dog.
Oh. A joker, are you?
No. I'm quite serious. I'd heard that you appeared to be rather overfond of our canine friends, you know, the racing kind.
Is that so?
And I've got a friend who's also very fond of this particular breed of animal.
Have you?
And he rather forgetfully left it waiting for him outside this certain little business establishment.
Did he?
And when he came out to feed it its mid-morning biscuit, he saw that it had decided to take a walk in somebody else's car.
Never.
Well, he wants the mutt back.
Does he? Sit down, Mr. Box. Hello, you're early?
Oh,
couldn't half murder a cup of tea.
Oh, I'm making this for Mr. Clark. So you see, Mr. Bucks, I'm going to have to keep your friend's dog till Saturday.
Yeah, yeah.
But not a word to a living soul, understood?
Right.
Tell your friend if he makes a fuss to remember the Godfather.
Godfather?
He could wake up one morning to find his mutt-severed head sharing his pillow. Understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Well, good day, Mr. Bucks.
Good day, Mr. O'Connor.
He'll have his dog back first thing Sunday morning.
Right.
And do yourself a favour, Mr. Box. Have a flutter on the second favourite.
Ta, I need a win. Guinness.
Guinness?
The dog likes Guinness.
So do I.
Yeah, but if you don't give it to him, he suffers from withdrawal symptoms.
What have I done?
You haven't done anything.
But I thought...
Well, you have done something. But it's something you've forgotten about.
Have I?
It happens to quite a lot of people.
Well, let's get it over and done with as quickly as possible, eh?
It's about your insurance. I'm from the company.
Oh, well, there must be something wrong. You see, I've always kept up the payments.
Well, of course you have. And now's the time when it pays off.
What?
I had to see you personally. The policy has matured.
Oh, my God. Tommy! Yeah. Oh!
Stoner crows.
Heir of the dog. I've found Mrs. McGregor.
What? Where is he?
Don't jump about. Don't jump about. Now listen. It's very tricky.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Mr. Clark. Goodbye. Ah, Tommy!
Oh, dear.
O'Connor's dog. The favourite does his leg in training. So all O'Connor's left with is a handful of non-racing dog meat.
What's that got to do with Mrs. McGregor?
O'Connor then goes in search of a ringer, doesn't he? And his runner, Alf, comes up with your mutt, but was quietly minding his own business outside Gil's shop.
I still don't get it.
Nobody knows that the fave's done itself, right? The punters and the bookies still think the favourite's running, and they substitute Mrs. McGregor for Bork and Prince. They put your mutt in the favourite's colours, and he comes nowhere.
But where's the point?
O'Connor puts his money on the second favourite, which can't be beaten, and cleans up.
Yeah, what do you mean, can't be beaten?
Well, your mutt's never seen a dog track in his life, has he?
Rubbish.
Eh?
Just don't race him, that's all.
What?
Take him coursing. One smell of a rabbit and he'll beat most other dogs hands down. You ought to see his timings.
Yeah, it'd be different on the track, wouldn't he?
I don't know.
Well?
Well?
Hardly winning the football pool, is it?
Oh, still. It's something, isn't it?
Robby's dad and me took that policy out 40 years ago, and £2,000 were worth a fortune. He was earning £250 a year, and we still had fresh eggs for breakfast every morning.
Yeah. And I could eat, drink and smoke for £3.10 a week, and go to the pictures. Yeah. It's funny, isn't it?
Life?
Life.
I think I'll invest.
Invest?
Well, let's look at it this way, Tommy. I didn't have it this morning, so I might as well put it away again.
Invest in what?
A little business I know of.
She's a diamond, you know. A 100% gold-plated diamond.
And then some.
Trouble is, you see, it's not enough, not by a long chalk.
Blimey, it's a start.
Yeah, but is it going to keep me out of the wooden overcoat Ronnie Day's having tailor-made for?
It might stop him putting the buttons on it.
Yeah. 48p.
Oh, no. Not with your mum's money, Rob.
Well, she said it was an investment, didn't she?
A eudoxeter, result of the pins on handicap. First, number two, magpie jewellery into one...
Are you certain? Look, I've checked all his timings, and he's got the age.
Yeah, but that's no certainty.
No.
When did you last take him out for a run?
I do it every week. Got to keep him fit, haven't I? I trail a rabbit.
Hey?
I get a rabbit, see? Trail it across a grass run and let him go.
That's a shame.
What?
But the hare's not a rabbit.
He's in the inside trap. One whiff of a rabbit and the other five won't stand a chance.
Gil!
Yeah?
Quick word?
No credit.
Hypothetical question. If I had 2 grand to put on a dog, what would that tell you?
Hypothetically, it would tell me that you know something I don't know.
Well, how would I get round it, hypothetically?
Well, you'd shop around, wouldn't you? Hypothetical 50 here, hypothetical 50 there.
Yes, that's what I thought.
Robbie?
Hmm?
You don't, do you?
What?
Know something I don't know.
No. Hypothetical question.
So, Fred, you can see her out.
Hey, Dick. What about them wheels, then? Get your own.
More to the point, what about a driver?
Get a cab.
Oh, God.
This fridge is frail.
You rabbit, it's not going to breed.
It's a club, not an abattoir.
I tell you what, Ferry, I know where we can go.
They're not in.
Oh,
probably gone round the pub.
We're going round there, then?
Nah.
What are we going to do?
We're going to borrow it, aren't we? Tommy won't mind.
But you haven't passed your driving test.
Shouldn't be on the road, Ferry.
Oh, for God's sake!
Oh, shut up!
Ah! From a jack to
a king. So this is it?
Hello, Jane. You weren't supposed to come until the gala opening ceremony.
My God.
Oh, you won't believe it when it's finished.
I hope not. What's the matter? Do you keep running out of materials?
No, it's just that Geordie has to work unsociable hours, you see. He fell asleep up the ladder last week.
Well, I hope you kept your job.
Well, I can always make a few bob, you know. Not really the place for Demi, I suppose.
What do you mean?
Well, you know.
No, I don't. Tell me.
Well, late hours, that sort of thing.
She seems to like it.
Oh, she's great. She's really good.
From what I hear, you're not far from the matrimonial stakes.
I don't think it's an up-the-arse job just yet.
From what I hear, you won't have any choice. I'll have a large vodka and tonic then while I'm here.
God's sake, Robbo, my stomach's back in the jumping line.
It's got a dodgy clutch, that's all. Look.
You can say that again. That is it, Robbo. I'm never getting in the car with you behind the wheel ever again.
Ferret, come here.
I'd rather pay for a taxi.
Good
do me a favour, Ferret. It's not me, it's the car.
You mean the car wanted to cross the roundabout?
It could happen to anybody.
No, it couldn't. It just had to be me.
I've just got to get the hang of it, that's all.
Well, do it on your own.
I wouldn't mind, but I'm only doing it for you, ain't I? You've got no bottle, that's your problem.
Give me a Guinness.
Princess, what are you doing here?
Came to see the decorations.
Oh, I told you to wait.
Oh, couldn't.
No, I didn't want you to see it till we'd finished. What do you think of it, though? It's good, isn't it? Obviously, I'm sure he's going to have to do a bit more.
Obviously.
Pretty long.
Half a vodka and tonic.
Did Dick tell you we've got a new name for the club?
New name?
Yeah. We're going to call it Oliver's, after you.
After me?
Yeah, Oliver's, in the hope that everybody's going to come back asking for more. Anything we can do for you?
Oh, you're getting to sound more like a club owner every day. Can I have a private word?
Oh. Debbie did it.
Looks lovely. And now you want to throw her out? I mean, up till now, she has been your only ally. And now you've managed to put her off as well.
What's wrong?
Well, how could you do it?
It was only a suggestion.
Well, she's taking it as fact. And she's not taking it too well.
I thought you'd be delighted if she didn't work here anymore.
What makes you say that?
Nothing.
I mean, when she goes, she'll go in her own time. Well, that's fair. What? And don't tell her I was here, will you?
Anything you say, Princess.
Good.
I'm sorry. We're getting like Tom and Jerry.
What?
Well, every time we see each other, we seem to go into one. I just can't take it seriously anymore.
What the hell do you mean?
There you go again.
Robby Box.
Princess.
You're right.
Ever since you came back. Hello.
Hello.
Apart from being lovers, which I know that we're not anymore, you were the best friend I ever had. It's a pity you can't drive.
Of course I can drive.
What are you doing now?
What, this minute?
This second.
Not a lot.
You fancy doing something silly like we used to do in the old days?
Is this a proposition?
Come on, let's go and stuff a hare with a rabbit.
Do what? This is madness, you know. I mean, you're mad, Robbie.
So's half the world. The other half's insane.
I've torn my bloody trousers.
What happens if we get caught?
You should have stayed back in the car.
What is this? You've got to be joking.
Listen, we're not doing anybody any harm. In fact, what we're doing, punters, the bookmakers, the authorities a favour. We're making a favourite win. We're right and a wrong, that's all.
You tried telling the magistrate that.
Come on, me beauty.
Oh, it's disgusting, this.
It's me lunch.
What?
I call them on Saturdays and skin them on Sundays.
What?
Look, I buy a rabbit on a Saturday, give Mrs. McGregor a run, then on Sunday, rabbit stew.
Oh, that's awful.
Waste not, want not, as they say. I pop them in the pot and add veg during the week. Marvellous. It's a delicacy, isn't it? I tried roasting them once, but it wasn't the same.
Wobblers.
Yeah, how do we know which one they're going to use?
We're going to have to do them all.
You can't be serious.
Hey.
You've got to be joking.
Of course not.
But one man and his dog.
Even I know the dogs come out about 30 miles an hour. Isn't going to make any difference if you put Chanel number 5 on them. They're going to be going too fast to notice.
Look, he's on the inside trap. The number one. The one with the hair.
The hair with the rabbit. The money's in the envelopes, right? 50 quid a time. Number of the dogs on the inside. Now, you're all going to get a list of bookies, all different, none recurring. All you got to do is hand them over the ramp and cop the receipt.
Run, rabbit, run, rabbit, run, run, run. Run, rabbit, run, rabbit, run, run, run. Bang, 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 goes the farmer's gun. Run, rabbit, run, rabbit, run, 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 run. Run, rabbit, run, rabbit, run, run, run. Don't give the farmer his fun, fun, fun. He'll get by without his rabbit farm. So run, rabbit, run, rabbit, run, run.
The dogs are on the
way,
second Ravens. The dogs are on the way. There are six runners in phase two. Six runners, they all run per program.
You must have done that in your mind.
Guinness?
Oh, yeah,
bloody
good,
eh? The dogs are on the way, second race. The dogs are on the way.
What race is it then, son?
He looks good.
Yeah, I don't look.
I've got my fingers crossed and my toes crossed and all.
Will you shut up? I'm trying to concentrate.
Yeah, did you fancy a couple of tickets for the Arsenal?
You what?
Next to the chairman.
You must be joking. I'm a Fulham man. That's you.
Isn't I?
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm getting a bit jumpy. I'm going out to have a look, all right? See you later. He's doing it again, isn't he?
Where did that money come from? Is it a game?
You're joking. It was his mum's insurance.
His what?
Well, it matured, didn't it?
Worked unheeded and all.
Well, how much does he owe now?
Well, he still needs four for Ronnie Day.
Well, for what?
Grand.
Oh, Robby.
And 770 for the piano player.
For the who?
Oh, it's a long story.
Oh, no.
And all that before he gets to the tax.
Oh, dear.
What's the matter with you? Oh,
it must be the pollen cap.
Eh?
I get hay fever.
Oh.
Only trouble is, so does he.
What?
I hope he can still smell the rabbit.
Ferret, you're a million, you are.
Well, if this goes down the pan, there is no way I can see him recovering.
You can always get a bowl of soup at the Sally Army.
What do you think, man?
I think that spot of paint in his nose could have been done by Van Gogh himself.
Where'd you get that knot?
Outside a betting shop.
You should have left it there. What did I tell you?
Yeah, you told me.
Another half a length.
Yeah.
And here is the result of the vote. First, chapter two. Second, chapter one. Time of race.
Sorry, Robbo.
28.91.
He ran a good race, son.
He did his best.
He ran a blinder. Well, I think we could all do with a drink, yeah? Come on.
Come on, you don't be upset. Come on, come on. Come on, come on.
Yeah.
champagne, tap order of the gods. And for you, what's the matter? Don't you like it? I do.
How can you drink champagne at a time like this?
Shh, 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 shh. And one for you, and one for me. Two, not one. What are you on about? Two, woof, woof, not one. Woof, woof.
What?
Oh, what is this? Give us a clue.
Yeah. You mean
warm?
You didn't bet.
Warm
on Mrs. McGregor?
You burnt your toes.
After all we went through last night.
Pitter patter, pitter patter.
What?
It rained, you burnt.
Rained?
Yeah, it poured all night.
Yeah. You mean he did it entirely unaided?
Entirely. I took O'Connor's advice. We did the two dog, not the one.
Mummy, Fox, I could kill you.
I don't believe it.
What does he mean?
Mrs.
McGregor.
Oh, Mrs. McGregor.
Oh, Mrs. McGregor.
Two, 4 to 1.
4 to 1. That's almost £8,000, Rob.
Yeah.
I stake money nearly 10.
Good old Robert. You're a genius.
I said that first. I go for that.
You wouldn't be interested in selling that dog, would you?
Well,
no way.
It's only a pet, really, isn't it?
Some pet.
This was your first test, wasn't it, Mr. Box?
Yes, that's right.
Of course.
Well, I never got round to it before.
No.
Well?
Well, thank you for some memorable moments. Is your instructor in the office?
He should be, yeah.
I'd like a word with him.
What about the code? Shouldn't you ask me some questions on the highway code?
Not much point, really, is there?
In June, find that now the kids are gone, life is happy ever after. Next. Set sail with the Uneeden Line, Thursdays at 9:30 and 6:30.
I will not stay another minute aboard this ship.
On UK Gold.
police drama in Juliet Bravo every Thursday at 10:30 a.m. and 9 p.m.
Do the world of good
on UK Gold.